Parapratibha. This is a Parapratibha concept I will explain just now. Maybe next slide, please. Okay, first I will explain and then go to this. See, ultimately the whole explanation in Sri Vidya philosophy comes like this. We accept Lord Parameshwara as a Nirguna Brahma. Just for the present, you don't worry about the name what I'm telling. Something we accept as that Shiva Tattva as the highest Parashiva. Nirguna Brahma, say, know this one. And the Saguna, at the next level, Shakti, which is not, which, you know, you cannot distinguish out of that one. It is always there with the Nirguna Brahma. What the Vedanti say that in Nirguna Brahma, Maya is attached, Maya is there. Maya after all comes from where? If there is only Nirguna Brahma, comes from Nirguna Brahma only, no? So, Maya is there. In the same way, that one, Shakti, she is not, it cannot be separated from that Shiva like that one. But Shakti creates this world, Shakti creates this world by a self-reflection of her thoughts or her desire to sankalpa to srishti, to create this world in a mirror. The mirror is also herself. So in the mirror, normally what reflects is, if I keep this one, the mirror will reflect this only, you know. But here, when Devi stands in her mirror, it reflects her thoughts, it reflects her desire to create that this one, and that flows in the form of tattvas. 36 tattvas are there, that is how the srishti takes place. And now in front of the mirror, I kept one beautiful bottle like this, I kept some dirty object, I kept something else. You mean the mirror gets spoiled just because it reflects that? It doesn't get spoiled. See? It just reflects, the mirror reminds us the mirror. So that is the way Devi reminds us Devi, nothing happens to her, but the creation happens like that one. This is the beautiful principle in Sri Vidya philosophy. You all may not have heard that one, but you can refer to chapter. What I am talking will be available to you there. So extending that, so everything in this world, now ultimately what we say is, this Nirupadika, Bhavanoprishad quotes like that. Of course, Bhavanoprishad will tell first about Lalita, and then it will go to Kameshwara. Bhaskaraya has very clearly said that these two terms, Kameshwara and Lalita, which you don't find any other text, especially in any other Vedantic text. These two terms are only this Upanishad mentions. In fact, nowhere Vedas also you will not be able to find that one. I mean, as whatever the available Vedas just now, Vedas are Upanishad. But only the Bhavanoprishad talks about that one, right? These three principles. What he says is that, you know, Sada Ananda Purna Swatma Eval, otherwise I'll start from the beginning. Nirupadika Samvit is Kameshwaraha. Nirupadika Samvit Eva Kameshwaraha. So just now I talked to you, Upadhi means some sort of an attachment. Either some property or some attachment. See, if it starts doing something like this, oh, this is a thing that does that. On Upadhi, something attached. But Nirupadika, no Upadhi at all. Purely a conceptual, that Brahman. And, but that is, this is, here is where the difference comes. That is pure Samvit. That is why our Shastram, Sri Vidya Shastram, is called as Samvit Shastram. It is also called as Ananda Shastram. If it is Samvit Shastram, Shiva based, Ananda Shastram, when we take a little more towards Shakti based or Shiva Shakti based like that. Pure Nirguna Brahma Samvit is Kameshwara, and the moment Sada Ananda Purna Swatma Eva Lalita. Ananda, he just explained in his day, cannot exist by itself. Sati Chiti has to be there for Ananda. And therefore, Bhaskaraya takes the term Sati Chiti Ananda Rupa along with that. He takes all the three together. The moment in that Nirguna Brahma, you add Sati Chiti Anandam, it becomes Lalita. And the moment in that Lalita is our own Atma, you add our Antakaranam. Antakaranam means our intelligence, Buddhi, Manas, these things, Chittam. It becomes Upasaka. He will call it as a Upasaka. It becomes a Jiva, like that. We become a Jiva. So Devi, we are all Devi herself. But then you have to understand this. See, it is very easy to talk something like that, and it will look funny also. And then you will hear and go away and like this, and something will happen. But these are all on deep contemplation. You will find a very great truth on that. This truth cannot be just realized by just seeing my slide or just hearing my that one. It requires, as I said, that one, Chitta Shuddhi and a lot of sadhana, and towards the end you can realize that one. And Jagat is all Tattva Srishti. I must have mentioned as Tattva Srishti, yes. Whatever the Devika, though I know, that concept Jagat is becomes this one. Next slide, please. Yeah. Yeah, see, ultimately we call everything as prakasham and vimasham. What we say in our Sri Vidya philosophy, suppose I got this bottle. Basically, there is something nirguna, without any property, what you have got of this bottle. The bottle has got a green cap, it is a label, it has got this one shape. Or without any of these things, there is something that is there. That is the nirguna brahmam, that is the prakashamsam. And on that you put all these properties, it becomes this bottle. See? Now, that properties are all devi. So, that, this property and that property, the party gives me ananda. Suppose this bottle is there, such a beautiful, tiny, nice bottle. On looking at it, I feel happy. Suppose there is a bottle which is odd shape like that and which is, you know, while for keeping itself falls down or something like that. I am not that happy, that one. So, ananda. See, in every small thing, that amsha, vimarshamsa, ananda comes. And that is where we Devi Upasaka always say, enjoy, see ananda everywhere, like that one. The moment you are able to see ananda everywhere, you are qualified number one Sri Vidya Upasaka. See, at that level. But along with all other earlier things, conditions apply, you know, I have said that, you know. So, prakasha, vimarsha. So, prakasha, vimarshatmakam, this prapancha. Next slide, please. All right, I want to go back to some these terms in Advaita. I have taken from a very knowledgeable person. Maya upalakshita chaitanyam. That means the Brahmam, out of that Maya has to come from Brahmam only. It cannot come from anywhere else, because in Advaita philosophy, ultimately, you have got only that Brahman, you know. So it represents that. Maya vichinna chaitanyam. That means where the Maya thing has come out of it, but it is not influenced by Maya yet. It has come out of it. I don't want to go further into that, already we are late. And the third one is Maya Visheshita Chaitanyam. In Maya Visheshita Chaitanyam is all where it applies to all of us, you know. We are all intermingled, we are all entangled, and all these things happening because of this Maya, effect of Maya, that one. See, Maya Sathram, that is what in Advaita says. Now in one great Upasaka from Bikaner, while talking last time, he just mentioned to me, Maya in the Saptashati, three Mayas are mentioned very clearly. One is Yoga Maya. Yoga Maya means that Maya always remains with Vishnu. Because he is sleeping, Vishnu is continuously sleeping. But Maya and he is not affected by that one. Yoga Maya is like I told you, Maya Upalakshita Chaitanyam. Mahamaya is that with which the creation happens. Creation itself is Mahamaya. And Vishnu Maya is something because of which we are all getting into all this mess and other things in our world, you know. That's why we just say, Ya Devi Vishnu Maya Yedi Shabdida, Namastase, 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 Namorma. Okay, next slide, please. Yeah, we have the Mahavakya word, Sarvam Kalu Idam Brahma. Everything is Shiva Shakti Mayam. Everything is Devi. And once you are able to see that one, then that is where it introduces all your later concepts, the universal brotherhood, that, this, blah, blah, all the good thoughts, good this one, and you know, without any desire, you don't get jealousy and other things because someone else is getting that one, which you are not got. All this thing happens when you really understand Sarvam Kalu Idam Brahma, in terms of that one. Next. And Sarvam Shiva Shakti Mayam, and Prakash Vimarsha Mayam, and Ananda Mayam. Ultimately, everything what you have to do, you have to remind with our Sahaja Ananda and giving with the whole thing. Enjoying the every aspect of our stay in our life here, every object. Next. Now you will just say, there is a Lalita Sahasramata Sarvan Ullange Shasana Karke, there will be one term, that one. And Lalita is worshipped also as Sri Mata, the next Nama is Sri Rajarajeshwari. Anyway, there are big tattvas behind it, I don't want to go more deep into it. But the moment you say Rajarajeshwari, then there is a Shasanam that comes. The king means he has got a rule. So what is the Shasanam of Lalita? Jagadananda Karakam is Lalita Shasanam. So Lalita, if you say you are worshipping Lalita, if you say you are worshipping that one, your duty is to somehow ensure that you make the world happy. You make all others happy with whom you are coming in contact. In your own small way, that one, make happy. Jagadananda Karakam is Lalita Shasanam. And how you are going to do the Paripalanam? Next slide. I don't know whether I have written that. Next. Now, we call our samsara yatra as not dukkhamayam, not this one, you have to leave this, go there. No, sahaja anandamayam anandam. Sahaja, I am born along with my inborn Ananda. If we see any picture of in a desert or something like that, not desert, in a vanam, in a forest, a deer will always be shown as, it will not just move, it will always jump with joy. Always it will be jumping with joy, you know. So every animal has got its own joy, you know. We should realize that we have our inherent joy. Our joy does not depend upon our senses, does not depend upon our what we have got in our hand or what is our current status in society, that is and all. It only depends on just our realizing, yes, I am Sachidananda Brahma, that kind of a thing. With that Anandamaya, Sakajanandamaya Yatra, Samsara Yatra is a Sakajanandamaya, you will do the Paribharanam of Lalita Devi's Jagadananda Karakam. That's what is Sri Vidya's ultimate, the philosophy. Next, please, last one, I think. Yeah, then I would like to offer my pranams to Sri Lalita. Because the Trishadi itself is very known as Lalita Trishadi, Lalita Trishadi. After all, I had got the clue from there, you know. So with this one, pranams to Sri Mata Lalita. And of course, one gentleman helped me, one Mr. Sundar Raman, that one. And I'm taking a little, liberty of putting my wife's name also there, that because we interact on these topics very much, every day, almost on a daily basis, you know. And therefore, at the end, I'm writing all this presentation has come from us, from both of us. And okay, that's it. I think Commissioner Bhumavadya. Okay.